What is up, my dear foodies? Welcome to one of the most requested videos on my blog, my skin and hair care routine. Now, in this video, I'm going to be talking about what are the products I use and how I use them. You don't necessarily have to use everything, or you don't necessarily have to follow everything that I am doing, but you can, you know, pick out a few things from here and there and you can implement it in your routine, which will be helping you out. But let's make something very clear, none of the products are sponsored, so sad life. In this video, I'm going to be talking about my skincare routine, my hair care routine, and some extra tips for better skin and better hair. Now, one of the most important factors when it comes to choosing cosmetics or the products for your skin or hair is that you need to use products, or you need to pick products that are natural, more natural, because if you use the things that have a lot of chemicals in them, yes, I agree, they might give you amazing results instantly, but in a longer run, they're not good for your skin or for your hair or for your body in general. Now, when it comes to cleansing, the simple routine I follow is WTF, which is washing, toning, and facial scrub. When it comes to washing, I use a simple face wash from Biotic. I use that because my cheek skin is very dry. The skin on my cheeks is very dry. So that is one of the face washes that does not dry my skin out too much. When it comes to toner, again, I use Biotic because it's really inexpensive. It's like 140 rupees or something, and it will last you forever and ever and ever. When it comes to facial scrub, I use facial scrub from Lotus. My sister bought it and I started using it, and there was nothing wrong with it. It was pretty, you know, it had a lot of natural ingredients, and also it is a good brand. And you know, you need to invest in yourself, your skin, your hair, your body. It's your temple and all that. Now, the thing about skin is it is a very porous structure. So it has a lot of pores for sweat to come out, for your protective oils to come out, and for your skin to breathe. So, you know, when the skin cells are dividing, they kind of block those pores over time. So what is important is you need to open those pores time to time. That is where the scrub comes in. Exfoliation, that literally means opening up the pores by removing the excess dirt and dead skin cells from your skin. And after you exfoliate, some of the pores might remain open a bit too much, which can lead to germs like bacteria and all harboring inside them, bacteria, dirt and all, which can again lead to acne, which is counterproductive. That is where toner comes in. Toner tightens the pores. So after you scrub, just tone your face. Just take the toner, a little bit of the toner on a cotton swab or your hands, and just apply it on your face every time after you scrub. Now, when do I use all the products? Face wash, I use it twice a day. And if I work out in middle of the day, or I do some activity which causes a lot of sweating, like I'm sweating right now, I use my face wash for the third time after those activities. So basically I use it two times a day at least. And once after any intense activity which causes a lot of sweating, or if I go out in the pollution and stuff, if my skin feels dirty, I use the face wash. When it comes to facial scrub, I scrub every alternate evening. So it's like once in every 2 days. But at least, at the very least, you can scrub your face once a week. That is like the very least. You will feel the difference. The thing about scrub is you can instantly feel the difference in your skin after you have scrubbed your face or exfoliated your face. Toner, every time I scrub my face. After I scrub my face, I apply the toner. That's pretty simple. Now, second point about your skincare comes to your lips. Lips, although they are a very small area, they are very crucial. The skin on your lips is only 3 to 5 cell layers thick, whereas on the rest of your face, it's around 16 or 15 something layers thick. So that gives you an idea of how thin and delicate your skin is, and protecting it is very important. So there is not much you have to do about your skin when it comes to your skin. A good lip balm is more than enough. The one that I use is from Ustra. I have been using it for, I don't even remember, I have been using it for like a year or a little bit under a year. It lasts very long and it's pretty cheap. I don't remember the price. I'll put it on the screen for you guys. The third thing about the skincare routine is a moisturizer. Using a good moisturizer is very important. I can't stress enough how important it is. The one that I use is from Wow. It is cocoa and shea butter. It's pretty good. I have been using it for quite a while now and I like it. I use it every morning on my cheeks only. I just apply it on my cheeks, nothing on my forehead and all, because kind of an oily T-zone I have, but my cheeks are dry, my skin is very weird. And on my arms and whatever, you know, you can apply it on your body. Moisturizer, very important. Now, the most important thing when it comes to using a moisturizer is how you use it. Most people just take it out of the bottle and apply it on your skin. there is a very small step, but it is very crucial. I can't tell you how crucial it is. When you take the moisturizer in your hand, rub it together for a few seconds. The heat generated will emulsify the active ingredients present in your moisturizer, and it will help for the moisturizer to spread easily over your skin. It's just like, you know, when you're drinking tea or coffee or soup, the warm ones taste better than the cold ones. It's because they spread easier on your tongue and reach more taste buds. So more than what moisturizer you're using, it's important how you use it. So take it in your palms, rub them together for a few seconds, and then apply it on your skin. Just a few seconds, but they are gonna make a world of difference to your moisturizing game. Now, fourth and the last point when it comes to skincare routine is, we have spoken a lot about my face. Now let's talk about my body, the rest of my body. Every morning when I'm bathing, I use a body wash naturally. And the one that I'm using is again from Wow. I don't remember which one it is. I have like two of them. I'll show you both of them on the screen. It's pretty good. The smell and the effect is pretty evident. So just use a good quality soap or body wash. It's not compulsory to use a body wash. Remember to moisturize after you've used it. Now let's move on to the second part of the video, which is the hair care. As you can see, my hair, if you ignore all the sweat I have, because I can't turn the fans on because of the audio issues. So ignore the sweat. Now, when it comes to hair care, again, the rule of thumb, I use natural products, and only two products are more than enough when it comes to your hair care: shampoo and oil. I oil my hair every third night, so it's like I am oiling once every 3 days. I leave it overnight, but it's completely up to you. You can either leave it overnight or use it an hour or 2 hours before you shampoo your hair. And when it comes to shampooing, I again use Wow. Even oil I'm using from Wow. I'll show you guys whatever products I'm using on the screen. So currently I'm using the argan oil shampoo and oil. Before this, I have used the onion black seed oil and shampoo, and also the Miracle 10-in-1 oils shampoo, something, I don't remember the name exactly. That shampoo was by far my favorite. It's even better than the argan oil one. So shampoo, oil, both of them natural, no parabens, no sulfates, blah blah blah, no BS. And when it comes to shampoo, I shampoo my hair every day. I use a small amount every day, which is not something I recommend, but you know, over the years I have learned that this is the best way for my hair, because even a single day if I don't shampoo my hair, it becomes really bad. You can shampoo your hair once every 2 days, or if you can go 3 days without shampooing, it's all up to you. I shampoo my hair every day. One pro tip, you can call it a life hack, and it's probably something that you guys already know. When you're shampooing or oiling your hair, you need to massage your scalp as much as you can. That stimulation, that massage will lead to, it will promote new hair growth, and it will make your hair healthier, basically. Now we have come to the last part of the video, but it is very important. These are some extra tips that I want to give you guys, which will help you up your skin and hair care game. Skin and hair care game. First and foremost thing is, you might have heard this before, you are what you eat. So I'm not saying don't eat junk food, but try to cut down on greasy junk food like fried food. If you are eating a lot of fried food, you might have observed that your skin starts producing a lot of oil, especially your face, and more oil equals more acne. You don't want that. I don't want that. Nobody wants that. The second point is, drink a lot of water. I drink a lot of water. I'm practically in the washroom half of my day peeing because I consume so much of water. I've even got some water here in a cold drink bottle. So make sure you're drinking at least 3 liters of water. 3 to 5 liters, good enough. A day. 3 to 5 liters a day. Now, third point is micronutrients. You know, we all focus on the protein we are eating, the carbs we are eating, and the amount of fats we are eating, the overall calories. But what we mostly usually neglect is the micronutrients, the vitamins and the minerals. So invest in a good multivitamin. It's like each bottle will last you for like 2 months or 3 months, depending on whatever you're getting, like 60 capsules or 90 capsules. Trust me, it is worth it. You will not see any difference as soon as you start taking it, but after you have used it for like 2, 4, or 6 months, you will start noticing a difference in not just your skin and hair, but also your energy levels and how healthy you are feeling and everything. The last point, very important, get good sleep. 7 to 8 hours is what is recommended, but PUBG, COD and all that is not going to let us sleep for that long, I believe. Whatever it is, try sleeping a lot in the nights. You know, it's not of the same quality when you take a nap in the afternoon. A long continuous sleep is far better than several small naps, if you know what I mean. Now that is it for this video, my dear foodies. I hope you guys liked it. I worked a lot on this video and literally I'm sweating. You guys can see it probably. I can't because there is this light shining on my face and I'm practically blind right now. And also I want to know what your tips are, like what are the things that you do for your skin and hair. Do let me know in the comments. It might be useful for me, it might be useful for someone else who's randomly going through the comments. Now I can finally stop sweating and get into something comfortable. This shirt is not comfortable.